Hi, I'm Audrey Rovato. Welcome to the D.E. Nichols channel. Today I have something exciting for you hiding right back here. I have installed an air intake system, a short ram to be exact. I know a lot of you are instantly thinking about that dislike button. You've gotten hot air into your engine, you have less power. That's true. I can't deny that. But I like it. Let me show it to you and I'll tell you why. I wanted to test it out before I showed it and talk to you about it before it turned out to be a complete dud and it was a waste of your time. Well, I would have probably told you about that too. It's too expensive not to make a YouTube video on it. First off, enjoy the pitter-patter of rain. Enjoy the birds. I love it as background. The last time I showed a short ram intake over on my old beast over there, my Chevy Prism, I got a lot of good views off of it, and I'm hoping this is even more popular because way more people love the Nissan Frontier than they did the Chevy Prism. Alright, so the concept of a short ram is to reduce how much resistance there is to get the airflow from the air filter into inside of your engine. Instead of having a complicated OEM mesh, which I'm going to actually show you and reinstall because this is my winter intake only, we have a nice straight line, perfectly straight. Now, a couple of things that I found to be issues on this, it wasn't too bad if the temperatures weren't too hot, but when things got really hot, they got pretty thrown off, is because I spent the $42 on eBay. Shipped. I mean, you could spend more money on just the filter. It's a oil-free filter. It's a great deal. We're going to look inside the pipe. I ran it for a couple of months. We'll see if any dirt's gotten through. But in the meantime, my concern is that I always thought I had a cold air intake. I mean, look at that. That's where it pulled the air from, right? No. Not really. That tube comes around in here, and I suppose it picks up some cold air while it's there. Comes around, comes to this tube, and that's your real air intake. So everyone thinks they have a stock cold air intake when they look at this at a glance, but I usually find engineers find a way around that. And this isn't an exception. This is the real intake, and it goes. There's an intake air temperature sensor, and it goes up there and around just to give the appearance of a cold air intake. Now, I wouldn't be surprised if the air charge cools a bit lit, but it also keeps it warmer. I tended to see a certain amount of difference in temperature from what the air was outside on the stock air intake to inside on the intake air temperature, checking weather. This intake air temperature would often say 6 to 8 degrees hotter. Once I got this installed, it tended to be a couple more degrees hotter. And it didn't really help that much. Sometimes I managed to get better gas mileage in the winter. That was my goal. We had an Arctic front come in that was about 12 degrees Fahrenheit. We usually don't see temperatures like that, like they do up in Steve Robb land. Great channel up there on YouTube. But we did. And I thought, I don't want to pay this much money. I never had such bad gas mileage in the winter, and I'm going to use this every winter, regardless of Arctic air, because it does help. And I actually can pause the video for a second and show you various uploaded pictures that prove that stock versus short ram, you're still going to have good power despite the increase in temperature in the winter. What you're not going to get, however, is as much power when it's warmer. I mean, I had a couple of good runs where my torque was a lot higher with this. When I was coming on it slower and gotten the higher RPMs later instead of really dumping on it. But typically speaking, horsepower was always down. And it's okay if horsepower is down if you have tons of torque down low. It's a truck. So more torque means, that just means you have more power coming in into the lower gear. Now, a couple of those issues that I was talking about. This intake air temperature sensor, if it's not hooked up to the stock system, it's not exactly the air that this filter is drawing in. So you could actually have some ability with this to tighten it up against the engine or put it out here. I chose to put it out as far as I could because, you know, you have a couple inches of working room with these good sills, good silicone sills, and you can get this to touch at least the back side of the sensor. I mean, the sensing side of the sensor is on the other side. It would be better if I were to modify this, drill a hole so this would thread in to like into here somewhere. If the wiring can get all the way over here, that would be better. If I'd been at the $120 intake when I was short on winter funds, shops are always slower in the winter, it would have contained a shield that would have wrapped around like this. Hopefully they sell those by themselves. And with that shield, it might have made the intake air temperature down here a little bit more accurate. But the fact is, the air that was coming in here wasn't drawing across the sensor. So if once it got really hot out one afternoon, I found that my fuel trims get thrown off. Let me back up. At one point, I didn't have this right on top of the sensor, and my fuel trims were pretty wrong. So let's say we have air coming into your engine, and that air is hot. And it knows it's hot, and it's accurate, and its fuel trims are close to zero. Now, let's say I get to start moving in traffic. The intake temperature sensor immediately comes down because there's actually a lot of cold air. Look at this. Up underneath the hood, down to this hole, right at this filter, and right at this sensor. Pretty close, anyway. But this short ran was actually getting way colder air than what the intake air temperature sensor was seeing. And when that happens, your fuel trims on short term are going to go rich. It's not that the engine's really going to run all that rich. The computer's quick with those oxygen sensors. It corrects it. And you don't ever notice a problem with how it's running unless it's like 20% wrong. Sometimes it would be, but usually less than 15% or even only 7%. But because the getting colder air than what the intake air temperature sensor, who was sitting in the engine bay more, versus this cold air coming in here, fuel trims got thrown off, and that could actually make you, for a moment, have more power because things were allowed to run richer than they normally would. Because of that, when I had some warmer evenings, I wondered if maybe my gas mileage was affected, but because, in general, only really cold air gives me bad gas mileage on this truck, it was a warm day, so I got better gas mileage. Anyway, that's enough about the system for the moment. I actually did way more experimenting than I could share, but I think that's enough for now so that you can absorb it. And if I have some really big stuff, I'll make a whole other video about other things I learned about by running this. Gather your tools, get to work, you get out there and work on something, do some experiments.